अभी के उकार उकान दरवा हम उकार मान ओड़ा दो प्रेज द लॉर्ड विजय हां सब के अंदर की वर लिया नहीं है हां 4 மணி தொடங்க போறோம் நினைக்கிறேன் 4 மணிக்கு தொடங்கிரும் நினைக்கிறேன் நீங்க வந்துருங்க நான் இங்க வந்தாச்சு நான் உங்களுடைய ஆடிட்டோரியம்ல தான் இருக்கேன் உள்ள யஷஸ்வி வந்து கூட்டிட்டு வந்தாருங்க உள்ள உள்ள தான் இருக்கு நீங்க வாங்க ஆ வாங்க வாங்க தேங்க்ஸ் வாங்க விஜய் காம்
Yes, no, really? Great. So when I was a 10-year-old kid, as I remember only that Shaktiman is another form of the father. With this smile of face, I welcome Abhigya and his family and you all for this meeting of Toastmasters. Before we could start the meeting, there are few ground rules we need to follow to run this meeting smoothly. So first ground rule is, all of you have a mobile phone with you? Landline, anybody? No way. Okay. So please switch it off or keep it in silent mode. There are 5 seconds to do that, please. Okay, second ground rule is, please avoid moving in and out when the speaker is on stage because it will distract the speaker. And third ground rule is, please avoid cross conversation when the speaker is on the stage. It will again distract the speaker. So with these three ground rules, I would like to start this meeting and welcome you all again in this meeting. I hand over the stage to Mr. President.
Years, I have the privilege of meeting them and calling them as a guest here, and they are here with us. I want to give you a brief introduction of them and him, Abhigya, Abhinandan, and their family. I am not Abhideya, sorry. I am not, I can't memorize so much as Abhigya. I have to go back and look at my sheet so as to introduce them. So. First of all, to introduce his father, Mr. Anand. Mr. Anand, basically he is from Tamil Nadu, but born and brought up in Bangalore. And he was in IT industry for 18 long years. And he has traveled 8 countries. And he tells that he has learned best lessons of his life during his sabbaticals. From past 3 years, he is trying to become an organic farmer, and he has left it to God's grace to help him. And so I welcome on behalf of Mysore Impact Lab, Mr. Anand.
Thank
continues the power behind Abhigya, how he gets so much of energy. It's her mom, Anu. Her name is Anu and she is from Mysore, and she is the driving force behind Abhigya's development, and she has spent considerable amount of time with her kids and their pursuit of acquiring knowledge. And she has changed every bit at her home from cooking oil to milk. She has transformed the kitchen, and practically she follows what are in these lights. She cooks in earthen pots using cold pressed oil, directly from oil mill, and she uses only Saindhava salt instead of the free flowing salt which is available in market. And she makes sure that her children gets to drink A2 milk from the ancient Indian cow every day instead of A1 which we get it from the other cows. She has ensured that we will all sit here and get the best out of our Abhigya. A warm welcome to you, ma'am, to Mysore Fat Club Package. And now to introduce Abhigya's sister, Abhideya. She is entire 18 chapter of Bhagavad Gita. She has chanted it uploaded in video. And she enjoys chanting slokas from Gita in various temples. And she has chanted in more than 40 temples till date. And she loves Carnatic music and Bharatanatyam. And she is fond of cows and believes that human civilization cannot survive without cows. And so she has started to give talks on benefit of cow protection as well as implication of cow slaughter. Wow. Our recent final talk on this topic were in GSS College and Vijayavitala Confederation of Indian Industry, Mysore chapter, etc. She composes her own poems and short stories on cows, God, and vices from modern life too. And she never eats any junk food and loves only home-cooked food. A DVD and MP3 sung by her along with her brother is completely from memory. It's available and it's released recently. A round of applause for Abhideya. And now to introduce the master, today's speaker, the keynote address here today will be from this guy. He's a child prodigy and he has won the He is the state awardee of 2015, and he is the youngest recipient to receive the certificate and cash reward from Jagatguru Swami Bharati Tirthaji in November 2013 for having chanted entire Bhagavad Gita out of memory with correct pronunciation, which he has learned within a span of 9 months at the age of 7. A DVD of Bhagavad Gita is sung by him as price at 150 has been released now, and he appointed as an acharya for teaching Bhagavad Gita online by Maharshi Vedavyas International Vedic Virtual Vedic University based in Gujarat. He is the youngest to pursue and complete post-graduation in Ayurvedic Microbiology from Rishi Karma Vedic Microbiology Research Institute. He is also pursuing his bachelor's in Vastu Shastra. He is also learning Jyotishasra and Ashtanga Hridayam. He is a crusader against junk food and has launched a program called Swachh Sharira. Under which he gives talks and presentations on impeding dangers of junk food to various clubs, schools and colleges for 2 to 3 hours usually. And he is featured as a public hero on public TV on 25th December 2015. He has also written a set of 10 books called Ad Stormers, targeting all toxic consumer products which contain complete information on the description and dangers of all toxic ingredients through caricatures sketched by him. We are extremely privileged to have prodigy, master, Abhigya among us. A warm welcome to him, and the stage is open for Abhigya.
Make a good person is what have been told in this. So we now see a set of people who were good in the ancient time and even now in the modern time. So first we start with the rishis and the munis, who were one of the greatest people because they were very honest. They did not want any kind of fame or any kind of wealth, name and such things around the country. At that time they used to write the Shastras and the Vedas, in which not only just religious things were written, but also in each religious thing, one particular science was explained completely. It evolved a few lines, great technologies like a test tube, baby technology, that one was also given. So Vasistha and Agastya Muni were the first test tube babies produced in a utensil named Vasativara. So that's the utensil, and in that they were produced. So they are the sons of Mitra and Varuna. So this is the story. And now we come to the thing. Instead of doing it the olden way, now people are doing it in a modern way. Stupid things, different kinds of things, as we'll see in the next few slides. So Avatar himself said the world is a dangerous place to live. Not because of the people who are evil, but because of the people who don't do anything about it. Many people are evil, but for every evil there's one good to do something to the evil person. But nowadays there's evil coming up every year, or maybe every day there's an evil coming up, and there's not a good person to push the evils out of our modern society. So that's why Advertiser has said this, and it's a very good saying too. So now we come to Rajiv Dixit, who actually speak on all of these companies that they were so bad, and talking about all of that, and he has lectures on every single company, what do they do, and the banking system. He speaks against every single company because not all companies are so good. They always have an eye on money everywhere. So money has become one of the greatest things for a person. It means that a person likes money more than everything, even more than his life too. Like some examples are Bill Gates and others. So this is Rajiv Dixit, and because he used to speak about all of this, he was murdered. And now we come to Dr. Vandana Shiva. She's the founder of Navadanya, a foundation in which she actually has a lot of seeds and has written a lot of books on organic farming and ways to farm organically so that we don't get into such dangerous problems, as you see. So that's why she's she's also a pioneer in organic farming and has made different things to save the farmers from these companies and these multinationals. So now we come to David Icke, another good person who has qualities of all girls think. So the greatest prison people live in is a fear of what other people think, is what he says. And he is on a worldwide wake-up tour in which he goes all over the world exposing the truth of this one evil force, which is called Illuminati, which controls every single bad thing in the world and is trying to make the world full of depopulation, killing every single person. So this is what... now we come to Julian Assange. He says, who has an iPhone? Who has a BlackBerry? Who uses Gmail? Well, they're all screwed, is what he says. So now, because of this, shocking the truth is, he actually gives private information about corporations to people outside. So now we'll see the next slide, how he is behaving. So that's what happened. So he is termed as a villain, whereas Mark Zuckerberg, the founder of Facebook, and he is termed as a very great person and the person of the year in Times Magazine too. So Julian Assange, he is the trouble of the year according to the Times Magazine, and Mark Zuckerberg is the person of the year after providing private information about people to these companies and then not despoiling the people's privacy. This is what they do, Mark Zuckerberg. And if anybody is doing something good, if they find out, they'll try to put obstacles in the middle. So Facebook is another big scam which is taking part in this. So we are out of Facebook. And now we come to, again, Mark Twain. He said, it's easier to fool people than to convince them that they are being fooled. So this is what is happening. So many times, a person sees TV, and then when a person keeps seeing TV, they feel what the TV says is the truth, and there's nothing else other than the TV which tells the truth. So that's why it's called a tell-lie vision, in which it tells you whatever is a lie, and it just tells you lies. So that's the work of a TV. And that's why you must never believe the TV in all circumstances, because the TV is a tool for these corporates to just control the people. So, for example, the US has created 50 false stories. 50 of them, false stories, everything false. They just created it. Just like how in a drama, they have to be actors and they have to make the drama look nice. In the same way, these presidents, these prime ministers, and these chief ministers, these politicians, and all of them are just acting and making it just look like a drama in TV for all of us. And we keep believing it. 50 false stories were created in the US, I don't know how many in India, but this is what has happened. So, Noam Chomsky, he is an international linguist and also a political advisor. The general population doesn't know what's happening and doesn't even know that it doesn't know. So, that's another thing. And the media is lying to you, of course. Think this much every day, only this much. If you think about this, you know the truth. So, better not think about it, is what they say. So, if you think any much about that much of thinking, then you know the truth, and then they don't want you to know the truth, so they are lying to you every day and making you feel that that's the limit of thinking. So now we come to the media can legally lie. It can lie if it likes, of course. As in 2003, Fox lawyers argued it was their First Amendment right to report false information, and they won. They had informed some false information, and then the government, of course, after being pushed by the people, just put them on a case and then ask them why they did it. But they said they have not done it, and then they were proved too that they have done it. After getting proved, they said that it was their First Amendment right to report false information, and then they won the case. So every single media has a First Amendment right to report false information, and these people can sit and believe what they say, thinking it's the truth. So these are all the weapons of mass deception. All of these different kinds of uses, they are weapons of mass deception. The US went on a war on Iraq just because they the perception that they have weapons of mass destruction. But of course the US has weapons of mass deception, which is it's using it all over the world against us. So, the whistleblower, I can't allow the US government to destroy privacy and basic liberties, the Guardian. So, he is Edward Snowden, former National Security Agency subcontractor. But because he was leaking the information about the government, because the government is really horrible. In our Shastras, in our Vedas, in our religious books, also, it has been given that when a king is evil or bad, he must be pushed off the position. So the same way he tried to just defame the government some or the other way, but he was just removed from his position. So in the US, already there are many things that you can't plant something behind your house, and if you plant something there are some goddamn bacteria there, so they can just arrest you and take you and put you in the jail for just planting a small seed. And then also other things. They have many sets of rules. And now they have abolished many things and they are trying to push off people from the land some or the other way, making corporates come and sit on all the lands and remove the people out, pack them inside these smart city apartments which are maybe just 200 feet, that's all, of living space. So that's such a horrible living space, and that's what they are trying to do. So Mike Adams, he's a health ranger report person, and he keeps giving the reports about whatever is happening around the world, shocking and bad about the government. And also, he has his news called Natural News, in which he leaks out all of this information. Now we come to the world-renowned herbalist, Dr. Scaby, another good person. So we got so many good people, of which he goes for one. So he said the herbs are for the healing of the nation to do it. And that's why he's a world-renowned herbalist, and he believes that herbs can cure anything, and therefore he's a man who can cure HIV, AIDS, diabetes, cancer, stroke, STDs, arthritis, sickle cell, and many more diseases. So that's why he is a world-renowned herbalist. Now we come to another good person. He loves Bhaskar, who gives a lot of information on the body anatomy, in which how to eat and how will the food get digested well once you eat. So all of that is given in his presentation. Dambhodar Pubhimanashtu Krodha Parushyamevacu Ajnanam Chabhidatasya Partha Sampadamasuri. So now we come to the demoniac things. So now all of these are demoniac things in our kitchen. So basically, it starts with a so let's have a simple story. First, it starts with this. You buy something from outside, loaded with chemicals. You take that, 50% poison. And now again, push it inside the fridge so that you feel I can eat it tomorrow. You know, just keep it for some time. Otherwise, eat it and then say that's enough. Just put it. If you're, and then not even giving it to anybody else, just put it inside the fridge. Then leaving it. The fridge destroys all the nutrients completely and also gives cancer. Finished. 40% more toxins inside. Now the next day, they come out and say it's too cold. So now we put it inside the microwave. Inside the microwave, again another 40%. No, it's gone above 100%. So now when so much toxin gets inside your food, the food becomes nothing. No nutrition and so much toxin. So this is what happens in a modern kitchen. An oven. And the oven is too also based on electronic things. So that again makes it fully toxic. The food that you keep inside the oven and the microwave and the fridge. This is what is happening in every single modern kitchen, and to the way they are suffering. So therefore, the only good way for us to be safe from all of this is cooking in mud pots, cooking in the olden way, because the mixie also is bad, the mixer, in which we add something and then we grind it, but after grinding it, the friction will destroy the nutrients inside. Again, it's bad for a person. So that's why this is the better way, as in Dutch, yeah, they say something, dosa to kallo, something. Yeah. So that's the better way of cooking anything or grinding anything. And the mud pot is again very much. So in the Gita, Krishna has not talked about all of this in detail about the modern world, how it will be some company called Pepsi, Coca-Cola, nothing like that. But he has given hints about it, that there will be such demoniac people in the world. Bahubhuta sarga lokesmin daiva asura eva cha daivo vistara shaproktah asuram parthameshnu. So there are only two types of human beings, the wise and the ignorant. There is no other kind. Nowadays we have now the British people had made so many different kinds of it made our country look like it's taken over by caste system. And they made it look like our religious scripts have given about the caste system. But they have changed the religious scripts and made it look like they have 5,000 different castes. So it's so bad, the caste system. But the Bhagavad Gita says there are only two types of human beings. Not this Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, which people get annoyed about too. So there are only two types of human beings, the wise and the ignorant. So this is the truth given in the Bhagavad Gita. Pravrittim cha nivrittim cha dharana vidura asuraha na shaucham napi chacharaha na satyam teshu vidyate asatya na pratishthante. So the Agenda 21 is extremely evil. So this is the main topic, and Agenda 21 is an agenda in which within 2100 they want to destroy the complete earth, keep only 1% of the population of the earth on earth, and the rest depopulation, finish everybody else. So you may see signs of all of this. They are starting to educate every single person that the world is not able to tolerate population. But the calculation of the census which they are using is all crazy and stupid. So it starts with a villager who's born in a village and then goes to the city. So first they'll count him in the village. He's born in the village. Then the same person goes to the city, and when he goes to the city, they count him again. Two. One person counted as two. And then to every person they'll be counting the same thing, and they are made to look like the earth has 8 billion of population. And even though the earth can tolerate it, they are just trying to prove it in the air that it is causing some crazy thing to the earth. The earth is going to be here whether our population grows to 100 billion or whatever. So that's why this Agenda 21, which they are trying to do, is to keep only 1% of the population, which are the super rich members of the earth, alive and adult. So you may see many signs of this happening. So these are 40 different things they want to do to people. Combating poverty. You know how they will combat poverty. The way they combat poverty nowadays. So the banks. The way the banks are moving nowadays, I don't think poverty will ever go from this earth. There will be hundreds of population who will be full of poverty. And it is the banks which do all of this. And without removing these banks, which are a source of money for this Illuminati or the 1% of population, without the banks they cannot survive. The bank is giving the space between the rich people and the poor people. The huge space. And the misconnection between people is made by this bank. And we are fools to see that piece of paper as money. This is money. But it's actually a bond that is coming from the treasury. So we'll discuss on the banking system that, in the other few slides. So all of these 40 chapters have, the red ones are highlighted, and they will give you a little of thinking on why it's so bad. Now we have come to Make in India too. Make in India means our India will be another China. If Make in India is totally made to India. If it is successful, India will become China. So in China, everything is made from inside the country. So this is what is happening. Okay, Agenda 21, sustainable development. Newspaper, you may have seen all this. Environment, what they mean about environment. If you see all of this, these words actually control a person's mind into believing the government is the person who will save us in all circumstances, and there's nothing to worry about anything. Everything is okay around us, as Noam Chomsky told in that. So environment, economy, equity, consensus, affordable housing. That means affordable housing means $600 per month. That is in a smart city, 200 feet, that's all per person to live. And all of that, that is for affordable housing. And action, protect, and friends of this, friends of that, friends of animals, friends of this, all of that. And action, protect, they took action on this. They're not doing any action. They're sitting around in their houses and having, they're just fine. That's what they do. They don't have any action, anything. Protect, preserve, quality of life, benefit of all. While they are doing no benefit to anybody, as here. Depopulation should be the highest priority of foreign policy towards the third world. Henry Kissinger. You may have a curiosity about who is he. He is the secretary and also a Nobel Peace Prize winner after saying control oil and control nations, control food and control the people. After saying such a controversial statement, and how do you relate it to peace? The same to peace. How do you relate it? And in the previous saying, where it says depopulation should be the highest priority towards the third world. Third world, that means all of these poor countries. Depopulation, that's why in India also they are putting HPV camps, polio camps. All of this which will lead to mass destruction of human population. For these two. So Agenda 21 is like this. Can I please ask any one of you to explain this slide in just few words?
Wolf in sheep's clothing.
Yeah, correct. So, how is it relevant to Agenda 21? Can anybody say that?
They're trying to sugarcoat the words and make us feel that they are a sheep, but in fact, you know.
Behind, they are a wolf. They want us to believe that they are sheep. That means they are very fine and everything is okay going around the world. But in truth, something crazy is going around, but we are not aware of that, which we must be. Now there's another thing. Here are a few of Agenda 21's objectives. So you can just read this, and this is what is happening now. Abolition of private property. This is what they are trying to do. They're trying to take property from people. And if the people take their guns and say no, we're not going to, because many people in the US have guns. Not yet in India. Not yet. They are not allowed it in India. They are allowed it in the US, so everybody has guns there. So if the government comes to say no, then they can lift their guns. So that's why the government is trying to remove all the ammunition from everybody and then make them helpless. That's it. Hands up, give your property, sign, get lost. That's it, finish. All the property is given off to the government. And they can do whatever they like. They can sell it to the corporates can enjoy a very nice life, the 1% population. So then, this is Illuminati, the New World Order. They have a name, the goal of the New World Order is one world leader, one world government, one world currency, and one world religion, which is this Illuminati. Atheism is one of the things they are pushing through this, the New World Order. Hypnotizing and all of this. Have you seen the TV? Sometimes the TV it flickers in some moments in some particular patterns which make you believe what the TV is saying is correct. So now we come to John D. Rockefeller, one of the most richest persons, who was such a miser that there's a story about him. That he came to India once and then there was a program. He dropped his 50 paise coin on the floor of the hall. That was a big, huge hall where they were having a program. And he went around with chairs and everywhere to find that one 50 paise coin. So he created the General Education Board, GEB, in 1903. If he wants the 50 paise coin, then why would he have invested so much money on the education board? That was because he knew there would be a lot of profit for him too from that. So now education system is also the same thing. It's a totally comp thing. And now he said, I don't want a nation of thinkers, I want a nation of workers. For whom? Working for whom? For him. And again, David Rockefeller, he said that give me the control of money, the British supply of money, and I don't care who makes the rules. So this is what he said. And David Rockefeller said, we are on the verge of a global transformation. All we need is the right major crisis and the nations will accept the new world order. David Rockefeller, that's what he said. So he needs a major crisis. A major crisis, which means Karnataka, Tamil Nadu fights, and then all of these states fighting, and then finally India, Pakistan fighting, and then some more countries fighting, US and Iraq, huge fights, every venues, these the CNN, this BBC, spattered out everywhere. It used people sitting in their homes and seeing all of this and getting mad at this news and then thinking all of that. That creates a major crisis when these guys are laugh and feel happy. The world is crying and these guys feel happy. So now we come to another Illuminati, one of the most influential people now, Bill Gates, polio vaccines. Now, 48,000 children paralyzed in India. How? Because of the polio vaccine. It causes this non-polio affected flaccid paralysis, which is a very dangerous syndrome, and that causes so much problem in children. It paralyzes children, and 48,000 tribal children were as an experiment for this in India. That's true. Third world, depopulation agenda should be the highest priority. Just remember that saying, and you know that is the basis of whatever these people are doing. Now we come to again Bill Gates. Bill Gates, extremely dangerous person, and he has been killing so many people in the world. Is one of the major tools of the Illuminati to just cut off the population of the world. And then this man, after killing 48,000 children in India, not killing all of them, paralyzing some and killing some, he gets the Indian Civilian Award. Congratulations to the Indian government. Thanks for giving an award to such an evil person. So now the government does not even know who to give an award, who to not give an award, and also doesn't know morals and ethics, and is sitting on the chair of control. How can we keep such a crazy government after giving awards to such evil people? So these awards, even Nobel Prize, is such a dangerous thing. They're making people believe the others are good by giving these awards. So now we come to the Panama Papers scam. Here comes Amitabh Bachchan, one of the most craziest liars in the world. He's trying to push this polio vaccine. After Bill Gates, he is the ambassador for the polio vaccine. And everywhere posters on a polio vaccine, after it's known very well to cause non-polio affected flaccid paralysis. If you don't believe this, you could Google yourself on it and you could see the truth going on about this. Then the Panama Papers scam, he's caught in the Panama Papers scam also. So the government was not doing anything about this. Somebody leaked it and then it came out in the full news. Otherwise the government, everybody was quiet, even though everybody knew about it. All these guys knew about it, but they didn't say anything. So now we come to this, the medical field, where medical lies are being given. Now we saw all these political lies. Now we are going to see the medical lines. First, all of these companies give you so many medicines and make you feel that they are helping you. But here are good people who are talking about against these evil medicines. Modern drugs and vaccines are proven to be a hoax in attaining health. They have brought false hopes. The vaccinations are not working and they are dangerous. We should be working with nature. Dr. London Smith, MD. So now, if such great people are talking about this, what are we doing? Has this saying ever come in the TV, even though he has qualified degrees too? They are only crazy doctors in our modern society talking about crazy things and then coming for a health talk. How many of you watch any health talk? Health talk? Anything about the health? About health in the media? Yeah, maybe nobody wants health also. So that's why, first of all, their health is also bad, and this is what it is. So the biggest lie Big Pharma ever sold, this is the one. The vaccines are safe and effective. This is what they do to every single child. Not only babies, but even big people and even children, everybody has to get vaccines. It was a very funny incident. One day some person came to us, he's an ambassador for vaccines in Mysore. He came to us sending many people and then came to us finally and said that, do you have any children at home? So I just hid under the bed and shut everything with my sister inside, and then my father went and told, we don't have any children at our home. And then that's it. And then that's why, because these vaccines are so dangerous, this NMR causes such a dangerous problem that autism, diabetes, cancer, and so many other things are caused by this NMR. Seizures, asthma, allergies, diabetes, autism, ADHD, autoimmune DX, and SIDS, all of these things are caused by vaccines. And here, do you know what's in a vaccine? You see here, aluminium and so many other things. So we see also mercury and lead also here. So now we come to this. Human DNA from aborted fetal tissue is in vaccines. Human DNA from aborted fetal tissues, 14-week-old babies or aborted babies. In the US, they are aborting babies in mass. They are just killing babies everywhere so that they are just telling lies to the parents that the babies are unhealthy and if they are born, they lead a very sad life and such crazy things are behind. Polio, drops of death. Post polio syndrome signs and symptoms. Sleep-related breathing disorders and so many others, as you can see there, they are all the causes of the polio vaccine. So now we come to this documentary, it's not a documentary, it's a movie and a documentary. So it shows all of these different things about the government, the companies and the Illuminati, how they mix together and form a mass destruction weapon for our world and a deception weapon too. Dr. Andrew Wakefield breaks silence on vaccine violence against children. Have you ever heard about this documentary or this movie actually? Have you ever heard about it? Maybe never, because the government, all of these people just want everything to be shut. Even I was censored in a particular organization. I was not allowed to speak on the government. Anything about the government. I can speak anything about governments, but nothing on the government in a recent organization. So that's why the government does not allow anything to be known to the people. And again, the next thing, two-time Nobel Prize winner Dr. Linus Pauling declared, nearly all disease can be traced to a nutritional deficiency. Nearly all disease can be traced just to a nutrition deficiency. So why do we go for vaccines, for this big therapies and chemotherapy and such things, when only a ginger can cure cancer? It's a fact. It's 10,000 times more effective in terms of cancer cell killing than chemotherapy. So that's why we have to go down to the nutritional level and not to the atomic, subatomic and the molecular level, where these doctors keep doing some research on some unknown atom and keep doing something that may help the society, but we don't even know whether it's going to help or not. So they are making us believe that the doctors can do something for us. And now we come to consumers. Here are all of these different kinds of companies, you see. Once a person buys something, you have to buy it again. So that's what consumerism is trying to do. And George Carlin said, he is a stand-up comedian, advertising sells you things you don't need and can't afford that are overpriced and don't work. And they do it by exploiting your fears and insecurities. And if you don't have any, they'd be glad to give you a few. So now we come to this. Exploiting your fears and insecurities by what? Seal of FSSAI, seal of FDA, seal of this different kinds of companies, even though that's not even work. Pay a little money, just some money, and then they will put their seal and everything is done. Even if they're having bugs inside a bar of Dairy Milk Chocolate, they call it FSSAI. Me and my mother were once in Germany when I was very, very small. At the time we didn't even know about any junk food. We were just opening a chocolate packet and we found bugs, worms, just crawling through the chocolates. Such a horrible thing. And from that day, when I was about 3 years old, we stopped eating chocolate now. And then trapped in a dungeon of consumerism and call it development. Development after making people buy crazy things and showing as if the economy is going very high in the country. This is what is happening by consumerism. People are thinking their country's economy is going very high, and then actually it's just in the same place. And you'll see the next slide. The 10 largest shopping malls in India. Here. These are the homes of consumerism. When we go inside a shopping mall, you may have gone for some toy. Maybe, just for example. You all want to go for a toy. Something else. So, for example, if you go for some product, you'll end up buying 10 or 20 products. You'll go for some particular thing, but you'll see 100 more and say, it's a lifetime chance. I don't think I'll ever be able to see this again. Spike off and such. This is the main thing that's happening around in the malls. Here, these people are just going around, flying around the malls everywhere and trying to buy some other thing, and if they don't find that, they'll buy another 10, 20 of something equivalent to that. And they say, then for one more month, I'm going to buy some more stock, as if they are going a huge fight under a fort. Before, in the forts, other kings used to attack, and these kings used to store a lot of grain inside the house, as if something like that is going to happen. So they buy lots of biscuits, lots of chocolates from the mall. I've seen some people carrying 2-3 loads of baskets out of the mall, and I was just shocked, what are they doing? And one person was taking a full of junk food, and going like this and feeling happy that the person has brought a lot of things and running out of the mall. That was very fun. And then here, capitalism is the astounding belief that the most wickedest of men will do the most wickedest of things for the greatest good of everyone. John Maynard Keynes, British economist. So he said this, the capitalism is again not a very great thing. The US is a full capitalism country, but now it looks like they're turning to communism by snatching rights from every single person. Can't anything in your home. So communism is also about keeping everything for the government. And here even capitalism is also doing the same thing. There's no almost everything. Because whether communism or capitalism, both are evil. So we have to come back to the ancient way of living, the ancient way of policies, and the ancient way of everything. So great infrastructure here, roads, highways and everything, but from where did this land come? This much land. For the roads to go all around the world, for some little corporates to go around the world. Roads are not needed for everything. And one person, yeah, I can explain this to, one person having 3 to 4 cars in the US. Even though the population is less, the cars are even more than the population of maybe 2-3 countries joined together. Even though their population is less than here one country, the cars they have are more than any other country in the world. So this is what is happening again. So now we come to high-tech services in hospitals in India here. Who can afford all of this? The 1% population. If they get some cancer, fight the cancer hard and then just come out of the cancer. But for poor person, here, they have suffered in such stupid conditions. Why isn't the government bringing rich and poor to the same level and treating them equally? After saying equality, this, that, fighting for caste system, fighting for this. Why are they not fighting for these two things where poor people are ill-treated and rich people are well-treated? This is the thing. Make way for hospitals? Why not make way for nutrition? Nutrition is the main thing, that's why we are keeping so many hospitals all over the world. But now, there are so many hospitals, but less nutrition. So many education foundations, but less education. This is what is going on. And so many schools, but less amount of thinking in children. Even though the children are capable of thinking more, they want them to think only this much every day. Same with children too. And here, market size of IT industry in India. US dollar billion. So now it's US dollar billion. So in 2010 it was 50, 2011 59, 2012 69 is the export, and this dark blue is import. This is export and this is domestic. So 2011 is 59 there, and the domestic one is 29, and it keeps growing like that, where it is more than $100. $100 billion US dollars. So this is what is going on. The IT industry is also really, really bad. It's like petrol, just this fuel. This is the fuel of the evil. And IT is adding petrol inside the fuel so that it's burning even more. That's how they are getting their business, these companies. They get their business because of IT, and IT is, that's why it's one of the most crazy things ever in the world. That its aim is to help the rich and trouble the poor. Basically, that's the only one thing which tries to do that. Technology addiction. Okay, all these companies are fueled by IT, so even technology is like that. So now we come to technology, in which children today, I saw in one of the magazines, they are appreciating a family who sits on books, so many piles of books, and sits with a smartphone. They were saying it's a tech family. Well, and now Albert Einstein said, I fear that day that technology will soak up for human interaction. The world will have a generation of idiots. This is what he said. And when a person keeps, human interaction means talking and that generates hormones in the body which make a person happy. But people just want to sit with their technology friends, iPhones. In the karate class where I also go for karate, mothers leave their children and sit on the benches with their iPhones with no other work to do. They can go home, make some snack, homemade for the children. But that's not out of the window. They want to do something crazy. And now we come to the government. The government's great expenditures for the greatest good of humanity. Now we come to the huge expenditures. Here we go. Budget 2016, Ram Jyoti Yojana aimed to provide power 24/7 to every house by 2019, says Piyush Goyal, minister of electricity. So now this is gonna make so much of money for the corporates, basically. And they're often pushing so much money for electricity. Where is it for such poor people? They are suffering without having food, and this government and this company is pumping money for this bullet train, for this movement of Hyderabad network and such things. Then desire to desire of our CM Siddaramaiah, cheap liquor should be available for the poor people. This is the desire of our CM. After 23 years, again, Karnataka issued 754 licenses for new liquor shops. Indian Express, 14 December 2015. This is what Karnataka is trying to do again. Here, we go. The ambulance. First the people have to drink. Fall on the road. Then they'll bring one ambulance. Then they'll make them sick. Bills are collected both by Siddaramaiah. Finished. He got a huge home. He got a nice car. He got a nice taxi service. Everything finished. He is happy after making us totally into chaos. Here, now we come to We Are Destroying Earth. This is the main thing. But these Agenda 21 are pushing it into warm and fuzzy words, making us believe that things are going on peacefully and everything is going on fine. But behind it, it is actually like this. Scientists are trying to prove that we have destroyed the Earth and we have to do something about it. We have to do something about it. But this crazy government has another ideology of this, thinking that we should make it a little more slow. To deplete every single scientific things in this one thing. Slowly. We are destroying environment, we are doing this, we are doing that, we are doing this. That's all. Slowly. One year daily. Nothing on environment. This is what they are trying to do. Now we come to junk food. What's all the fuss about junk food? Basically. So now we'll see about it.
Just a second. This presentation will run for exactly the same amount of time that it has run now. So I would like to know from the audience if you're okay to stay back, or we should stop it at this, because I've been given 5 more minutes and then the Q&A. Because only now we'll be starting with the junk food. So if the hands are raised, then we can know the number. This is for staying back or for leaving? Okay, thank you. So, what should I do?
Since we have announced that the time is 5:30, those who are getting affected because if you are clashing with some other meeting or some other engagements, you may please leave. But the people who are interested, I request you to stay back because a lot of information he wanted to share. So,
actually, the shocking information begins now.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. So, we continue.
So, now we come to these different kinds of junk foods. Again, these are all so dangerous. One by one, we know about each and every junk food. What's there? Right? Toxic food. I told that story. It starts how two parts and then how that. So refrigeration causes cancer. Microwaving causes again cancer. And cooked in aluminium or non-stick vessels, it causes paralysis. And also it causes brain damage and so many other diseases. Hot food served in plastic containers, again that causes severe cancers. And processed and packaged for long shelf life, again all of these preservatives and emulsified hydrogen and that cause disease and chromosomal damage and also automatic or autoimmune diseases. And all that. And then incompatible foods cause leukemia and also indigestion. Rubber mat ingredient in azodicarbamide in your breads, pizzas, pizza bases and all of that. Azodicarbamide, McDonald's and also all of these companies who manufacture bread have admitted that they do add this chemical, azodicarbamide. And aluminium in your ready-to-eats, because they just want the population to get reduced. So again, in ready-to-eat aluminium, that causes Alzheimer's. Here, no man's photo has been given, but don't get it. You just don't feel okay about it because only when we become old, we may get Alzheimer's, but till then everything is around. It's not like that. You can get it any moment, Alzheimer's. Some people even forget the date, even though they had seen it in the morning. Some people also forget their own names in the highest case. And one woman had kept, and not an old woman, one woman had kept the water on and left the baby in and was looking at the lizard for a long time. The water filled up and suffocated the baby and the baby died. When she came to see, the baby is already dead. Finished. This is called Alzheimer's. It's not only for old people. It happens when the neurons die in large numbers. So, so aluminium basically goes to kill the neurons in large numbers and in such a way that the neurons cannot reproduce even more faster. So the healthy brain is that much size, as I have given outer diagram, and the shrunken brain is the other one with Alzheimer's disease. So now we come to Parkinson's disease, which is again caused by this aluminium. So it's again an old man's photo has been given, but don't again be thinking that it will only be for old people. It's also for young people. You may have seen many people shaking, grunting asleep. It's not that they are showing that they want to say something or it's not a way of communication. They are shaking involuntarily. They don't know how to keep the muscles in control. So this is what happens. When the first what the full aluminium does is, when it gets inside the body, there is a particular connection between the muscles and the skeleton and the nerves, which form our body to lift our hands and pull it down to do whatever we like. Everything is controlled by this tribe, like this. So maybe not everything, but it's one of the concepts. So now, when that does not happen, when the aluminium kills these receptor cells, which take in the information from the transmitting neuron. If this is the neuron and if it's talking, okay, for example, I am talking to my friend, but my friend is not able to understand what I am talking. So, then what happens is, there's a misconnection. When the misconnection happens, the body is not able to act properly on that topic. So, the same same thing. It's happening here too. Let's go find it. That information is also released from the neurons. So skeletal deformity is also caused by this. So the cartilage erodes and then skeletal deformity happens because of aluminium. High intake of aluminium, which keeps getting stored in the body, never gets out of the body. So if you have aluminium food every day, you're at least going to have lots of aluminium in 1 month. And that lots of aluminium will give you leg pain, and in the end of the year you have at least one major problem and you'll be in the hospital. That is the problem. So pink slime in your eyes means, you'll be wondering what's pink slime. As you see, it's the mashup of all private parts and also soft parts like eyes, nose, mouth, which cannot be consumed by people. That's all mashed up and they can make a liquid out of it. This is the pink slime thing. And that is added in your favorite ice cream. And proof, Baskin Robbins has admitted that they do add this dirty slime inside their ice creams. You can see the video too. That's the conversation between this John Robbins, the son of Baskin Robbins. And he has a conversation with him. I don't think you'll get this because they don't allow it to be seen. And then Baskin Robbins slowly admits that he is adding all of this. So above the human fecal tissues used as taste enhancers in all products, especially anything owned by Pepsi, Nestle, and Cadbury Adams products. So above the fecal tissue is used in all of these things. Nestle, Mountain Dew, Pepsi, Tropicana, these are all the things, main things here. And Starbucks, coffee, so that the person feels that they have had again and again. If a tiger has eaten human blood, if I just taste him, human blood, then he will not eat anything else other than human blood. So this is the saying in Kannada, Manushya Rakta Ruchiyara Puli, like that something. So that saying shows that when a tiger eats any human, it will not like any other animal. So that's how they're making us do. When once we have this aborted human baby fecal tissue, we will never like to have any other thing. The added tissue is interesting. Very subatomic level like that. So now we come to lead and mercury in your noodles and pasta. You may already know this. High levels of lead, mercury, TV, tissue and all that. And here, 2 minutes may khushiyan. Happiness in 2 minutes. Again we get to the Panama paper scan part. Hello. And 2 minutes may barbadia, not khushiyan. It is barbadia in 2 minutes, not khushiyan in 2 minutes. Maggie noodles is just like that. So, have you felt sick lately? But I would ask you, have you felt sick lately like that? With this chocolate, because it contains slimes of it's called soylacetin in your chocolate, and sulfites in your chocolates along with soylacetin, which is a GMO product, as you see the next thing, whatever happens by GMOs, sulfites in your chocolate. And again we came to the next one. So can anybody remember what all ants this Amitabh Bachchan has covered?
Navratna Tej.
So now, kuch meetha hota hai, he says. Is there nothing meetha in our ancient thing? Everything is kora. Everything is bitter. Is nothing sweet in our ancient thing? There are millions of sweets and we still have to go for this crazy chocolate filled with chemicals and advertised by such themes, of course. Poison in your milk. Again, we come to this. Arteriosclerosis, sudden infant death syndrome, autism, schizophrenia, ischemic heart disease, type 1 diabetes mellitus. That is A1 milk. So A1 milk is basically from... So why is this A1 milk? You know what is A1 milk and what is A2 milk. The difference between these two is they have a 209 chain protein, of which the 67th is a protein chain, which is actually protein in A2, becomes his cleavage. That means blood vessels, stopping of the blood vessels from flowing and other things. So this is what happens when a person drinks A1 and A2 milk. So now we know what is A1, what is A2. This is A2 milk, that is A1 milk. Before, the Westerners had named this A2 because they thought this cow's protein was less and that cow's protein was higher. So they got A1, bigger and greater. And this one A2 because they thought it was bad. So evidence shows cow's milk is a link to solving medical mysteries from diabetes to autism. Jersey animal misled as cows these days. It's misled to more to be known as cow, not even a buffalo. It's no animal basically. It's created scientifically, so-called scientifically. From now on, depressions will be created scientifically. So that's what he said. A congressman and a solo. Flight first solo. I just forgot his name. I think Charles something.
Lindbergh.
So poison in every sip. Now we come to coffee. Poison in every sip. Why? Because it contains caffeine. Caffeine is one of the most dangerous toxins, and it's a neurotoxin. It makes a person lazy. First makes a person very active, and next very lazy. I see this slide. With coffee, do stupid things faster with more energy. You get energy, you do things faster, but you do things stupid too, which spoils both these two. So, caffeine addiction chart. It first starts like this. Caffeine consumption, then heavier breathing, increased mental and physical fatigue. Now again, the person will want to have caffeine. Again, caffeine consumption. So it keeps going like that. And now another caffeine addiction chart. Caffeine constricts blood vessels of the brain, low caffeine level, sudden increase in brain circulation, headache. After this, again the person feels, I have a headache, so I think coffee is healthy. And again, drinks coffee, again the same thing happens. That's the reason why headaches are so popular nowadays. So this is the chart of the main symptoms of caffeine overdose. You can see it. Central muscular, respiratory, urinary, systemic, gastric, heart, skin, ears, and visual. So this is coffee. Osteoporosis. Definition of osteoporosis is when the bone matrix, the muscle bone matrix, is expanded to become very porous, many more, which are foolish. Except some very educated countries in the Europe, they have banned it, but other countries are still having it, like uni things for these companies. In the companies feel it's an experiment, it's a profit and everything together. So all your biscuits are very, very bad. It gives a cocaine-like addiction and makes a person feel that they have to keep having Oreo again and again. So this is what happens when a person has Oreo. This is a cartoon. This addict, he's been twisting, licking and dunking since his early teens. Hey, you punk, I want my money. That's all he wants is money. And this man is on the bed. Call him. Drug addict. Finish. So equal to drug addiction is what we are knowing. So MSG, all packaged food, every single junk food has MSG, monosodium glutamate. Again, extremely bad. Now we come to health drinks, the so-called health drinks. So these are Complan, Horlicks, Boost, Milo, Bonvita, all of these are known to make a child feel that prepared for the exam. But it's really nothing. Like Boost is the secret of our allergy, they say, but I think Boost is the secret of our allergy. But do you get so much money by telling lies, these two? So here we come, Sachin Tendulkar. So both of them are such big liars, and even though they hit a 6, they are still giving 6 lies to every person. Every time they hit a 6, they'll give 6 lies. Now we don't even see both of them. In the middle, whenever these cricketers get breaks from having a match, they are into advertising. So they basically are being used as tools. Once they hit a 6, everybody says, yeah, 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 and then goes back home. When they see the TV, their ad will be coming. So, yeah, he's a fan. He's also having this boost. So he won't be that. Fine. I also started hitting 6. Then that's what happens. Again, the person becomes so crazy after eating this because it contains artificial protein isolates and also so many emulsifiers and high levels of salt and aspartame. So now we come to aspartame. It's present in all so-called sugar-free products. So don't get fooled when any product says sugar-free. Aspartame killing you sweetly. Here, aspartame side effects. It's 200 times more effective than sugar in sweetness. Reduced vision, headaches, migraine, epileptic seizures, severe depression, irritability, phobias, different kinds of phobias. Some people have 5, 6, 7, 8, and I have only one. Hemophobia. And also, severe and so many other diseases, including this one dangerous one, tumor. So, energy and sports drinks, these are the ones here. All these contain caffeine, L-carnitine, yogurt, inositol, quercetin, and sodium hexametaphosphate, as you see, sodium citrate, sodium benzoate, potassium sorbate, caramel color, benzoic acid, sorbic acid, and then this brominated vegetable oil, in which bromine is added to vegetable oil, which causes dangerous problems, and potassium benzoate, all of these, and citric acid, calcium, lysodium, EDTA. Then we come to the disorders it causes. Heart arrhythms, irregular heart palpitations, increased blood pressure and dehydration, gastrointestinal problems, chest pain, dizziness, headache, and even death is caused by all of these energy drinks. So, Pepsi okay, aapke pe kya tha? This is what it is. You can use a Pepsi better to clean the toilet than a bottle of Harpic 2. And the same way it won't clean your organs. When it goes inside the body, when it tear your organs, corrodes everything. The reason why it's able to clean dirt is, it's able to push the dirt off the surface because it has chemicals just like soap. Like EDTA as you saw. So now, cancer bhi hoti hai risk se. So naam karte hai risk se is what they say. We say cancer bhi hoti hai risk se. Again we get Hrithik Roshan. Two times brain surgery, underwent brain surgery twice and comes for Mountain Dew as a test. So this is the problem again with such people. Happiness Coppola, here we come with Deepika Padukone and Farhan Akhtar. So this is the thing. First we see Happiness Coppola, in the next slide you're going to see the depression of this actress. She's complaining about depression. She's crying in the interview with that Barkha, the India top most journalist. In any TV channel, you could watch it too. That she's complaining about depression, bringing crocodile tears and doing all of that. So then, why didn't she bring a bottle of Coca-Cola with her and feel happy as she was advertising in the previous line? So GMO in almost all processed foods, GMO, this is genetically modified organisms. These are present in all processed foods and they cause autism, they cause diabetes, they cause sterility, they cause infertility disorders and so many other problems. So these are the factors which create all of this. So new study, children in GMO soy growing region of Argentina have genetic damage here. So that's what happens. So children are suggesting that they are not science experiments then. So Dr. Ayagurai said that if Monsanto can disprove his claim that there are no safety assessment standards for GMOs, he will give the company a $10 million. He's the inventor of email, Dr. Ayagurai. So now we come to Dr. Barwane, a partner in crime with Monsanto and Mahiko. He is the CEO of the company Mahiko and Padma Bhushan Awardee and World Food Prize Awardee after doing such a big crime. As you see, Monsanto and Mahiko, these are partners in crime. They are trying to destroy the world fully with these GMOs. Meet Bill Gates. This man owns 5 lakh shares of Monsanto stock. In 2012, Mr. Gates stated that Monsanto, a company that again, we come to Bill Gates, to a horrible person who has been doing the worst things in the world. So the hypocrisy of the government, Michelle Taylor, former VP for Public Policy of Monsanto. Here, I poison the food supply, Monsanto. Keeps poisoning. And the same guy is the Deputy Commissioner of Foods, Food and Drug Administration. So what will he do? So first he is into food production. Second he is also into the company. He's in the government too. So what will he do? He will do good things for his government only, isn't it? This is what it is. Food and Drug Administration, Monsanto. And they both are joined. The Food and Drug Administration always does good for Monsanto. Monsanto has been filed so many cases and they have come to the Food and Drug Administration. But always the case is run by Monsanto. But the same person is in the government, the same person in also in the conference. So because of all of this, because of these seeds, hybrid seeds, you keep planting hybrid seeds, then the plant will not grow properly. No, it grows, but then again if you take seeds from that plant and try to plant it again, it will not grow. So 4 lakh farmer suicides have happened from 1997 to 2015 and it's still counting. Every day one suicide of the farmers is being heard. So sterility, this is what is happening. So now we come to the movie Ricky Donner, in which there's one father for so many different kinds of children all over the world, and then what if one day one person comes and they both marry and then become incest, as you see in the next slide. This is what happens then. So how many of you have seen Ricky Donner, and how do they show that concept as good or as bad? They show the concept as good, so that's why it's very bad. So now, Illuminati, the transgender agenda exposed. So now, this transgender agenda is again very popular nowadays, as you see. The transgender agenda, boys turning into girls, girls turning into boys, tomboys, and then transgenders like this, and they're pushing it, like in the movies too, IA movie, current movie, in which transgenders are pushed so much. Even in so many songs, it's only transgenders singing singing the songs. So they're trying to make everybody transgenders. Here, the Tamil movie Irumugan, in that also, he becomes a transgender. So all of these movies, they are being pushed with the agenda of transgenders. They're trying to make everybody a transgender. Here, the music fan of transgenders, there you see. All transgenders, everybody is becoming a transgender nowadays. Almost everybody. Because of, and then they're getting surgeries also done. So born Krishna, now Naina. You may have seen this video in which they have so many different companies have sponsored for this program of hers. They keep giving money for this to be pushed. Why? What benefit do they have out of this? Once a transgender comes, babies can't be born. So depopulation again. And making the world mad basically. So again, that is also very bad. Born Krishna, now Naina. This is the problem. Transhuman agenda. This is again another agenda. After the transgender agenda, we come to the transhuman agenda, in which people are turned into robots. This one is also, this culture is pushed a lot. People are encouraged to study robotics very deeply and then use the robotics for what? Of course, for making a person into a robot. As you see in the movie of Rajnikanth, who is another cheat, huge director. So again, we are already living in a zombie apocalypse. This is what is happening. Zombies are the creatures, so called. They are called transhumans. They keep getting drugs, flaka and all of that. It's called flaka, the drug, which is so addictive that when they eat, they go naked, they run, they hit people, they bash people. They are seeing something that is not even there in the world. If somebody is coming towards them, they think a monster is running towards them and they become very scared. So this is the main problem with flaka. So flaka signs are agitation, death, extreme aggression, psychosis, which were not at all there, saying things that are stupid and such crazy things. What is Plato's qualities? Now we come to transhumans, Pushkin movies, Robot, the movie. How many of you feel Robot is a very great movie? Not for its acting, but for the concept it's pushing. Good, nobody. The reason why is because they're trying to, first in Robot, they showed that they were creating a robot. The next one, they're turning a human into a robot, in Robot 2. So now this is so dangerous that they're pushing this, and children everywhere were saying, I'm robot, and this, and that. In other of my government school too, I studied in a government school, and there they were saying, robot, robot. Now they're saying, Kabali, 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 and running government school. So, now we come to CIA, Pokemon Go. So Pokemon Go is a very nice game. How many of you have seen this way? Okay. So Pokemon Go is basically controlled by the CIA, Central Intelligence Agency. It's funded by a software company. CIA funds a software company which has made this Pokemon Go. So why does the CIA need Pokemon Go? Can anybody explain? The Central Intelligence Agency, owned by the government.
To identify where the people are.
Of course, right. So, to identify where people are. So people, not only normal people, sitting in their rooms, fine. People like Julian Assange, good people, people who have exposed the truth on all of this. And those people, they send these Pokemon Go to be going like that. Some monsters they keep on a particular house where that good person is living, or they want to spy on that particular place. Apple, the company, had done this once. They have their police, secret police. They have murdered some 10-20 people just because those people spoke against Apple. They are secret police followers. So killing you softly, all of these things, water-based, scented color, and nail polish, pH balance, so-called pH balance, lather, these are all killing you softly. So many dangerous diseases. A woman applied color and 2 days she just died, flat dead, finished. Sometimes colors after the age 38. Daily application. When any person becomes 38 after daily application, not daily, weekly application of hair dye, dies after 38. Otherwise, if you have not done weekly, monthly, will give a dangerous heart problem or something like that. So fluoride in your toothpaste. You can research on all of this. You'll get complete information on all of this. And I also got it out from there, from the internet. And fluoride in your toothpaste, microbeads, two in your toothpaste. Microbeads are tiny plastic beads. And fluoride is a dangerous cancer causer and also is a tumor causing agent, and also causes teeth erosion and is so-called decay stopper, but actually it's not at all good for decay. It actually corrodes the teeth along with the decay germs. Cyclozan in your soaps, which mixes with fluoride in the water and then changes to, of course, cyclozan and fluoride turns into a very dangerous potion which will make your body get completely destroyed with hundreds of different kinds of cancers. The pharmaceutical industry does not create cures, they create customers, like the psycho, the psychotropic drugs. Again, they are also very bad, killing you brutally. They are killing you brutally here. So, Make in India. Now we come to Make in India. Why it's so bad? Make in India is again so bad because Make in India pushes consumerism. It pushes consumerism and makes India turn into China. That's it. We'll have factories every single place in the world, just like every single place in India, just like China. Everywhere, factory, and the leaves are coated with black thing. You can see the documentary China Today and other ones. So Make in India is going to make another China out of India. Grab lands, weapon or what? Basically, what is that they are trying to do to our country? They are trying to make it so crazy by putting all of these bullet trains. Now, who would want to go on a bullet train, basically? What is the job to go in a bullet train? What's the necessity of the life? Bullet train is the main necessity of the life. What is the reason behind this? The people feel bullet train was a very essential thing for the country.
FPD.
Not Saudi. Huh?
FPD thing. Post it.
What?
Every selfie, you can post it in online.
Facebook.
Okay, Facebook and all of that. Maybe only for that, but for that, is the government going to waste 98,000 crores for just a Facebook photo? 98,000 crore project to lay India's first bullet train network between commercial nerve center of Mumbai and Ahmedabad. It's for commercial. It's basically, everything is basically commercial nowadays. So that's why this deal was made by these two people. These two people who are very, very foolish. Controlled by the Illuminatis. Whatever the Illuminati says, that's how Narendra Modi will go. If the Illuminati says go to Japan, go there and get a deal with that, they go. How much ever the cost is, whether it's 98,000 crore or all the money in the world. So here is what happened. Corruption, the national drink, common man's blood. Politician. That's what they're trying to do. They are pulling out work from the people and then torturing them like this. This is what is happening. So, George Carlin, he's a stand-up comedian from 1937 to 2008. Okay, government don't want well-informed, well-educated people capable of critical thinking that against their interests. They want obedient workers, people who are smart enough to run the machines and do the paperwork. And just dumb enough to passively accept it. This is what they want, the crowd. This kind of a crowd who has all of these crazy qualities. So if a person is thinking little more than that, they immediately shut that person out of the crowd. That's what we are doing. George Carlin, this kind of comedian. So now we again come to the director of the Bank of England, Josiah Charlestown. He said, it is easy to dodge responsibilities, but we cannot dodge the consequences of dodging our responsibilities. He said that. And that's why we have to follow this one. The government has its responsibilities to protect the people. But it's just doing whatever it likes. Some crazy things which are not at all needed. For and then doing things which will lead to one another problem. Science solves one problem, but be careful. It creates another. By solving this one problem, it will create 10 more problems. To solve each one of them, it will create 100 problems. And that's how the science works, basically. Modern science. Padam vishatakruran samsarishu radhaman Kshipanyajasravashubhan Asurishveva yogishu. Trividham narakasyeran Dvaramnashanam atmanah Kamakrodhastathanobha Tasmadetatrayantyajet. So now again we come to Vijay Mallya, was rather 9,000 crores of Indian money. And now we move on to the next slide. Here, Vijay Mallya is also a liquor man. He's trying to make so much liquor, he's made our country full of people are addicted to wine. So this is what it is. Mallya Hospital. First he makes the same thing, just like Siddaramaiya. First make the people drink, make them fall on the road, then bring the hospital. So this is one particular thing which is very astonishing. April 2002, elected to Rajya Sabha. October 2004 to April 2008, member consultative committee for the Ministry of Defence. June 2010, elected to Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha and consultative committee for the Ministry of Defence. Such a evil man, manufacturer of liquor, put in Rajya Sabha. And now he has made such a huge loss for Air India, 30,000 crore rupees of loss. And also, he has taken away 9,000 crore money of the taxpayers' money. He has taken that everything. It's not the bank's money, it's not the government's money. It's our taxpayers' money. We are paying the tax and he's taking it and he's run away. Government? Okay. Everything is okay. Finish. This is what is happening. When Uganda becomes a way of life for a group of men living together in society, they create for themselves, in course of time, a legal system that authorizes it and a moral code that glorifies it. So this is also very important, that when Uganda becomes a way of life for a group of men living together, so some group of men, the group of men is that evil force which is Illuminati. So when Chanda becomes a way of life for them, what they do is they create for themselves in the course of time a legal system that authorizes it and a moral code that glorifies it. So this is what they said. And this is very important, and that's how the companies are pushing themselves with the help of the government into the media, with the help of the media, and with the help of the crowd too, of course. They are helping them. Wrong is wrong. Even if everyone is doing it, right is right, even if no one is doing it. This is what it is. So, that's why how much ever anybody is doing wrong around you, try to do something right, even though only you are doing it right. So the market strategy. Know the mind of the buyer, target group, touch emotions through burning issues, study buyers' income, create ads that become social culture, hypnotize into compulsive buying, mind control through constant ads, glamorous launches, and enamor with celebrity endorsements, flood media with repetitive advertisements, offer discounts, vouchers, and giveaways. This is the market strategy. And now you will say your strategy. Just ignore all ads on mainstream media. Stop buying anything that is packaged. Educate yourself through alternate media like naturalgeist.com, gmwash.com, and all of these websites. If you get into one, you'll find the truth of every single thing. Natural News is one of the best ones. So, spread the truth for at least one new person each day. Buy veggies, greens, and fruits from street vendors. Buy unpolished, organic whole grains. Buy unrefined, unprocessed products only. Yashastra vidhimut sridhya vartate kamakaratah nasa siddhima vapnoti nasukham naparangatim tasmat chastram pramanate tarya karivasthitau nyatva shastra vidhanuktam karma kartum iharhasi. So now, according to these two shlokas, we act according to the principles of religiousness, which is dharma. That means care. So all of those qualities there. You have to be good totally according to the dharma. Only, and you must follow each one of the duties, religious duties, and then the duty of protection, the duty of writing manuscripts and studying them for the help of everybody. And the duty of doing all these religious things is for every single person. If a person is a Muslim, please read Quran. If a person is a Hindu, please study all the Hindu texts. If a person is a Christian, please study the Bible and the other books also. Competition is every human's prime duty, and my sister will speak about it now.
Just 2 minutes. Just give her a mic. Just 2 minutes. 2 minutes, huh? Just 3 slides.
Give it.
She can take the mic also.
Yes, just.
She can take that mic.
Oops.
Okay, speak without the mic, Avidya.
Jai Shri Krishna, cow prediction is every human's prime duty, and human civilization will not be alive if cows are slaughtered like how we are doing now.
Now I'd like to open the floor for questions. He is ready to take questions from the audience. First question will be from me. Is that okay?
Yeah.
How to grow in
brain?
60 is my weight, your mom told.
Yeah.
And I want to make it 70. So what is my food? How should be my food habits?
Eat rami more.
Yeah, that will make a person, and if a person is fat also, ragi will make them thin. And if a person is thin, it will make them fat. Fat means not too fat. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you saying that before these junk foods were into the market,
maybe 50 years or 70 years back, there were no diseases?
Not like that, but there were less diseases. Now there are more.
Yeah, the
gateway
is also
more. Okay, any other questions?
Yeah.
So,
how can we overcome
these challenges? So, we'll take from ma'am. Yeah, your question is
A2
milk or
A1
milk?
A1 milk is bad. A2 milk is very, very good. So, we must use A2 milk, which is from the naughty cow or the cow which has a hump.
So, is your question about Nandini?
Yes.
Okay, Nandini milk.
Okay, Nandini milk is one of the most possible human milk. It has RTHD hormone. RTHD hormone, which is being banned in Europe, and so many other countries, and it's bleached. The milk is bleached, completely bleached milk. And it's added so many preservatives, and also it's so dangerous. So, Nandini milk is horrible.
Okay, yeah, your question.
So, how should we overcome the ill effects of GM foods? Because right from the seeds, they are hybrid seeds.
Yeah.
We need a normal life in a metro or in a big cities. So how are we supposed to overcome it? Or like what all can we avoid?
So first we have to get out of the metro cities. When everything is available, when we come to these villages, when we come back to the villages which are now just unknown places, it's a discovery if we find some village nowadays in Gujarat or in the north of India. To find the village will be a discovery here because almost there are many people in most of the villages there. So if we go back to the villages and if we get seeds from the people who have the good seeds, like Navadanya, that's an organization. So for there also you can get seeds of all different kinds of vegetables. So then you can get out of GMO. And there's so many vegetable vendors who don't have GMO. On the street, street vegetable vendors on each should be given from not from more this that. They have the correct tomatoes, everything. And the correct tomatoes which are very small and which are a little sour, they are the good ones. And the cucumber also. There are many different kinds of things. I try to grow everything yourself. That's also a very good thing.
Any more questions?
The average life expectancy is increasing in spite of all this. How do you explain the situation?
Yeah. It's actually a hope that the average life expectancy is increasing. In our Puranas, it has been given that the life of each person in the Kali Yuga will be 120 years. And there are many people in the past who are living for a lot of time. But now, it's not like that. People are dying 50, 40, some 30, and some even 11, and some 10 because of cancer, serious diabetes issues, and others in maybe 60. People are glad to see their 60s comes. So we can't say life expectancy has increased.
Yes.
So
what do you think about that? Aloe vera.
Abhigya, I'll put this on YouTube. The speaker gone crazy.
What?
I'll put this on YouTube.
Okay.
Speaker gone crazy, pushing chairs. Speaker sister also gone crazy, pushing chairs around.
Well,